Welcome back to Morning After, everyone. It is 10:15 here on this Friday morning, and Operation Kindness is the leading life-saving animal shelter in North Texas. Ed Jamison is their CEO, and he's joining us now with some tips on how to adopt, especially during the holidays. And Ed, I want to start with that because I'm wondering if there are any special considerations during the holidays when it comes to adopting pets. Do families, for example, maybe rush the process because they want to have the pet there by Christmas Day?
I don't think so. I mean, at any time, it shouldn't be a surprise. The family should have talked about that they were wanting to add a pet. It can be a great time because people are typically off work, off school, and, you know, and at their home, so they'll have that extra time to be able to spend with the animal. But you shouldn't surprise it when there's never been a discussion about adding a pet. But it can be a really great time if everybody's on board.
So that's the tip. Don't surprise someone. Make it part of the holiday process, and then just celebrate your new family member on Christmas Day.
Exactly.
I hope people know this. We stress it a lot. We talked about puppy scams the other day and people losing money. That's one aspect. The other thing is when you buy from a breeder, you might be perpetuating a puppy mill. You don't really know where the dog is coming from. Those are just a couple of the reasons why people should be going the way of rescues, but stress to them the importance of it, what it means to our community.
Well, that's it. Again, and there are reputable places, but it's so many rescues and shelters that are doing the work day in, day out. Animals by the tens of thousands coming in. Operation Kindness, we've been in existence for over 45 years, so we are, we're reputable. We stand by the amazing animals that we're helping out. And when you're adopting from a shelter, you're saving two lives. You're opening up another space for the next the next animal that needs to fill in that spot. So, we're on pace to do nearly 6,000 animals this 12-month period for us since we've opened up.
6,000. How does that compare to years past? Is that a record number or is that an average number?
Yeah, no, it's definitely record number for us. And again, the team is really focusing on with our partners. It's been a really rough year in the animal world with COVID, mm-hmm. and not as many people coming out. Mm-hmm. So we've been doing everything we can to be a good resource to all of the government shelter partners that we work with.
So many cute ones, including the one you're with. Okay, tell me who you're with right now, because he's about to climb the wall there.
Yes, this is Moonbeam. She is so, so sweet. A 7-year-old shepherd mix, came from one of our partners. She had some medical issues, a really upper respiratory infection, as well as we had to do some pretty major dental work. And I know she jumped off here now and is looking out the window at the other office dogs, but it's just the sweetest, sweetest dogs. And we have so many dogs and cats just like Moonbeam that are great. They needed a second chance, and we were happy we were able to be here to give them that.
We've had this conversation before with other animal rescue advocates. I've sort of seen it for myself. When you begin to care for them and you get them the dental work and you get them the health treatments they need, they really do come alive. It's almost as if they know you've helped them find a new lease on life.
I would absolutely agree with that. It's why I've been in the business for so long. And in these just very, stressful times that we have ourselves in, I'm really, really convinced that these family pets oftentimes are the things keeping things together and keeping us positive, because these animals, they just want love. They just want companionship. And so when we're dealing with all of the hustle and bustle of our daily things that go on, and you come home and your pet is there, just with greeting you with a smile and a kiss on the face, that's really hard to beat.
Yeah, it really is. All right, so we have a minute left here. Let's just take people through kind of the actual logistics. They visit you where, and the process looks like what? What's the paperwork? What's the timeline? How do you vet them? How do you know it's a good match? All of those things.
Yeah, we have a great team and really work hard to have our team working in the right spots. Some are more in the animal care, some really, really love helping be that matchmaker in our client services. But all of our animals that are available can be seen at operationkindness.org. You can come to our shelter at 3201 Earhart in Carrollton. We're also at the Galleria until next Friday. On Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, we've been at the Galleria. That's been extremely successful. And again, it's a well-trained team. Their job is to talk to you, have a conversation with you about what you're looking to add for your family, and then we do the best that we can to try to match. The team works really, really hard to try to get to know the animals as good as we can. And we are in the process of switching to paperless, so we're really proud of that, that we're trying to gather the information that we need to gather that helps us match you and not have to use as much paper in the process. But yeah, it's pretty seamless. We get a lot of compliments about how the staff interacts with patrons when they come to our facility.
Yeah, you guys have a great reputation. It precedes you for sure. Thank you, Ed, for being here with us. Have a great holiday. I'm glad it's been a good year so far and that people are extending themselves. I think that's a good sign. OperationKindness.org, they're on social media as well. And again, there is Earhart Drive. That's their actual shelter. You can go there and visit, but his integration with Operation Kindness at Galleria Dallas, which gets so much traffic, as he said, has also been successful. So it's nice to see those partnerships as well.
Yes, and make sure you check the hours for Galleria, because if you go there and they've gone for the day, there are little stuffed puppies in there.
Oh, instead of the actual dogs.
Yes.
You've seen that.
Yes, well, Brighton was like, all excited. I was like, oh, we're gonna go see the animals up for adoption. We got there, they were like stuffed, and she's like,
they're not moving.
Well,
what's going on?
This is not what I wanted.
Check the hours. That's the last tip. All right.
Oh.